We look beautiful.
There's your bride.
Let's try for no reason. Let's see what these wheels land. Let's grind down the curve of this earth. You look fine in the evening. Honey, it's starting the storm. When we kissed in the car, in the school parking lot, where I'd go with my friends to get drunk. Used to wish I meant anything to anywhere, to anyone. When forever was a sentence to death. Oh, when you were a running tear, I was a drop of sweat. And the edges of your soul, I haven't seen yet. Now I'm glad. Won't be alone for the rest of my life. I'll build a boat for when the river gets high. And I'll meet a girl in the heat of July. And I'll tell her so she knows. And I'm broke, but I'm real rich in my head. That I broke a bone that never healed in my hands. When I hold her close, I might loosen my grip, but I won't ever let her go. I won't ever let her go.
I'd like to welcome Amber and Zach to your wedding day. We are here for the sole reason to celebrate the two of you and the love that you found in each other. So if you could please stand and hold each other's hands and look at those hands you're holding. They say that hands are the connection to our heart. Those hands are those of your best friend, steadfast and strong. They're the hands that will comfort and support you in times of need, and also the hands that will celebrate with you in all of life's joyous moments that you're about to begin to share together. These are the hands that will work alongside you and hold your future together as one. And those hands, with the slightest touch, will comfort you like no other. This celebration today is but an outward sign of the inward union of two hearts. And as such, marriage is the most tender of all relations. Today is more than just a ceremony, it's a lifelong covenant.
Your soul is so pure. You're kind, sweet, gentle. Your heart shines wherever you go, and to witness this has changed my life. Zach, from our first date to 5 years later, on a mountain sharing our vows. Sorry, I'm so good. I knew from our first moments together that we were different. Our love started young.
Amber, I can't help but to think about our first date and then just think about where we are now. The fact that we had crossed paths so many times and never met makes me believe the timing was perfect.
By the love that they've displayed and by the authority vested in me by the great state of Wyoming, but much more importantly, with just sheer utmost joy, I would like to now pronounce you husband and wife. Will you please seal your vows with a kiss?